doing something.
No, I'm saying, no, the brakes. Guys, why aren't the brakes working?
Because I cut the brakes. Wild car, bitches.
Yeah! What?
It was even a conversation. I always assumed we would be heavily involved.
Yeah. This is bad. We gotta definitely write a song about how we do not diddle kids. Do not diddle kids. It's no good diddling kids.
There is no quicker way for people to think that you are diddling kids than by writing a song about it.
You gotta write a song. It's just a, ooh, I wouldn't do it with anybody younger than my daughter. No, little kids gotta be big. Older than my wife, younger than my daughter, something like that.
Don't write a song about that.
No. I'm cloudy. I got a headache. Whoa, whoops. Oh, I dropped my monster condom that I used for my magnum dong.
I'm out of here.
You came at the right time.
Is he sleeping?
Yes. He's sleeping right over there. Just the way you like him. Did you bring the toll?
Confound your lousy toll, troll.
God damn it. Stop laughing at me.
You gotta pay the troll toll. If you wanna get into that boy's hole, you gotta pay the troll toll to get in. You want the baby boy's hole, you gotta pay the troll toll. You gotta pay the troll toll to get in. Troll toll.
What'd you say?
Troll toll.
Here's your toll, troll.
Your boy awaits.
At last, the boy's soul is mine. Give me that leg, boy.
No.
Dude, do you have a boner right now? Shut up, dude. Don't ruin this for me.
What? What the hell are you? Jesus. Okay, stop. Stop. That's enough, dude.
Does it hurt?
Oh. God.
Integrate into a liquid lung and organ gumbo soup.
That was my line. Nice.
Charlie, I can't do
this.
Just
get to the money part, all right? Just get the money part done.
Give me money. Money me. Money now. Me a money needing a lot now.
That was Charlie's line.
Nice doing business with you, huh?
All right, Shanty.
Enjoy it.
All right, enjoy yourselves.
Boom!
Okay.
Hey,
we did it. We made every single one of our patties dollars back,
buddy.
You're
damn right. Thus creating the self-sustaining economy we've been looking for.
That's right.
How much fresh cash did we make?
Fresh cash?
Yes.
Well, zero. Zero if you're talking about U.S. currency. People didn't really seem interested in spending any of that.
That's okay. So, when they run out of the booze, they'll come back in and they'll have to buy more patties dollars.
Right.
Keeping it moving.
That is assuming, of course, that they will come back here and drink.
They will. They will, because we'll redistribute these to the shanties, thus ensuring them coming back in, keeping the money moving.
Well, no, but if we just redistribute these, then people will continue to drink for free.
Okay.
How does this work, Mac?
The money keeps moving in a circle.
But we don't have any money. All we have is this. How does this work,
dude? I don't know. I thought you...
What? I thought you were on top of this.
You're the one that came up with the plan.
Did I come up with this
last night, dude?
Oh.
With the DMB power card and the...
I blacked out that night.
Shit, dude, I've been following your lead.
Oh, Jesus. Ah, shit.
Okay, so we have no money and no inventory. There's still something we can do. That's still a business somehow.
How does DMBs do it? They got a complicated system worked out, and I cannot begin to understand it.
How does a self-sustaining economy work?
I don't understand how the U.S. economy works, much less some sort of self-sustaining one. I don't understand how finances work.
Shots for everybody!
This isn't fair.
Oh, is it not fair? Okay, well, if you're scared, we don't have to do it.
Okay, well, listen, if you insist, that's fine.
I do.
Let's do it, yeah.
Okay.
Ladies first.
All right, let's do it. Go. Yeah. Go, waitress, go! Okay. Get all you got.
Time for a show.
Didn't know you could kick it.
Oh, yeah, you could kick it.
And that's fine.
Yeah, yeah, okay, do it.
Okay,
go.
Good.
Show what you got, Dennis! Come on!
Come on.
Let's go, buddy! I summon the very fact that I am a man!
I have defeated you, and of course I have. I've been blessed with the genetic gifts to do so. Single bone in my hand. I cannot bowl.
What? Really?
Listen to me. There's nothing solid left in there. It's just bloody soup and bone broth. All right, now I need to scream. I need you to find me somewhere to scream so I don't have to do it here. No, wait a minute. I'm going to scream here and now, because I can't hold it in, so here we go.
Yo. Hey, buddy. I got some turpentine, some wax, and some high-gloss boat paint. This shit is really expensive.
Oh, dude, yeah, you're telling me. I picked us up some new slacks and docksiders so we could have the right look, you know, and fit in and everything. We're running pretty low on remaining dick towel money, though.
Plus, we gotta fill that thing up with gas.
I know, man. We gotta pop by the department store, pick up the mattress. I wanna get a nice one, too. You know what I'm
saying? The what? The mattress? What do we need a mattress for?
What do you mean, what do we need a mattress for? Why in the hell do you think we just spent all that money on a boat? The whole purpose of buying the boat in the first place was to get the ladies nice and tipsy topside so we can take them to a nice, comfortable place below deck and, you know, they can't refuse because of the implication.
Oh, okay. You had me going there for the first part. The second half kind of threw me.
Well, think about it. She's out in the middle of nowhere with some dude she barely knows. You know, she looks around her. What does she see? Nothing but open ocean. Ah, there's nowhere for me to run. What am I going to do? Say no?
Okay, that seems really dark.
No, it's not dark. You're misunderstanding me, bro.
I think I am.
Yeah, you are. Because if the girl said no, then the answer obviously is no.
No.
But the thing is she's not gonna say no. She would never say no because of the implication.
Now, you've said that word implication a couple of times. What implication?
The implication that things might go wrong for her if she refuses to sleep with me. Now, not that things are gonna go wrong for her, but she's thinking that they will.
But it sounds like she doesn't want to have
sex
with you.
Why aren't you understanding this?
I don't...
She doesn't know whether she wants to have sex with me. It's that
she doesn't
know. That's not the issue.
Are you going to hurt women?
I'm not going to hurt these women.
Okay.
Why would I ever hurt these women?
I don't know.
I feel like you're not getting this at all.
I'm not getting it.
God damn. Well, don't you look at me like that. You certainly wouldn't be in any danger.
So they are in danger.
No one's in any danger. How can I make that any more clear to you? Okay? It's an implication of danger. You know what? Just drop it.
Let's drop it.
You know, just buy your shit and let's get out of here.
You sure about this? Yes, dude. Sean DeMont is an asshole. He stole our bikes and he stole our identity.
I can't believe he's getting away with this, man.
You know what? We gotta do what we should have done 30 years ago.
Yes. Yes. You're right.
You ready?
Yeah, Sean DeMont, that prick.
Son of a bitch.
That goddamn prick.
Yo, I'm gonna steal my dad's vape pen. I know where he hides that shit.
Hey, you.
Hey,
supposed to be.
Bob Dylan, man.
Jesus Christ, we're all
check
over
this out.
The place.
Is this a page from a coloring book?
No, dude, that's Nightman. Those are lyrics.
Whatever. Let's
Nightman,
just rock.
Baby.
God cave, this is what I'm talking about.
Yeehaw!
All right. Where's my curtain?
Charlie, don't worry about the curtain. You're not going to need
it. Blocking my face.
Ernie, you don't need
go
it.
On. Go have a beer, Ernie.
Okay. All right. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8.
Nightman! Sneaky and mean. Spider inside my dreams. I think I love you. You made me want to cry. You made me want to die. Every night you come into my room and pin me down with your strong arms and pin me down, and I try to fight you. You come inside me.
Charlie, hold on a second. I mean, the first half of that song was kind of cool, but what's with the second half?
It's about the Nightman, like, you know, like filling me up and I become him. I become the spirit of the Nightman.
But it sounds like a song where a man breaks into your house and rapes you.
What, dude? Where are you getting that from? All right, no. It's just two men sharing the night. It might seem wrong, but it's just right. It's just two men sharing each other. It's just two men like loving brothers. One on top and one on bottom. One inside and one is out. One is screaming, he's so happy. The other screaming a passionate shout, it's the Nightman. The feeling's so wrong and right, man. The feeling's so wrong and right, man. I can't fight you, man, when you come inside me and pin me down with your strong hands, and I become the night, the passionate, passionate Nightman.
They're on to me, dude. Those guys are sharp as nails up there. You can't put anything past them. Oh my God, dude, I'm freaking out. I am so stressed out. I feel like I'm having a panic attack.
You wanna talk about stress? You wanna talk about stress? Okay? I've stumbled onto a major company conspiracy, Mac. How about that for stress?
What the hell are you talking about?
This company is being bled like a stuffed pig, Mac, and I got a paper trail to prove it. Check this out. Take a look at this.
Jesus Christ,
Charlie. That right there is the mail. Now let's talk about the mail. Can we talk about the mail, please, Mac? I'm dying to talk about the mail for you all day, okay? Pepe Sylvia, this name keeps coming up over and over again. Every day, Pepe's mail's getting sent back to me. Pepe Sylvia, Pepe Sylvia. I look in the mail, well, this whole box is Pepe Sylvia! So I say to myself, I gotta find this guy. I gotta go up to his office. I gotta put his mail in the guy's goddamn hands. Otherwise, he's never gonna get it. He's gonna keep coming back down here. So I go up to Pepe's office, and what do I find out, Mac? What do I find out? There is no Pepe Sylvia. The man does not exist, okay? So I decided, oh, shit, buddy, I gotta dig a little deeper. There's no Pepe Sylvia, you gotta be kidding me. I got boxes full of Pepe. All right, so I start marching my way down to Carol in HR, and I knock on her door and I say, Carol, Carol, I gotta talk to you about Pepe. And when I open the door, what do I find? There's not a single goddamn desk in that office. There is no Carol in HR. Mac. Half the employees in this building have been made up. This office is a goddamn ghost town.
Okay, Charlie, I'm gonna have to stop you right there. Not only do all of these people exist, but they have been asking for their mail on a daily basis. It's all they're talking about up there. Jesus Christ, dude, we are gonna lose our jobs.
Well, calm down, because here's one thing that's not gonna happen.
What?
We're not gonna get fired.
We're not?
Because we've already been fired.
We've lost our jobs?
Yeah. About 3 days ago, a couple pink slips came in the mail. One for you, one for me. So what did I do? I mailed them halfway to Siberia, okay?
If we've lost our jobs, that means we've lost our health insurance, which means all of this was for nothing. God damn it, dude, I'm having a panic attack. I'm actually having a panic attack.
Will you settle down and have another cup of coffee?
I am, bro.
All right, well, fine. You know what, Barney? Give this guy a cigarette. He's freaking out.
Huh? Who?
Barney. He's the guy who tipped me off to Pepe Sylvia.
Barney? Who the hell is Barney?
You don't see Oh, shit. What the hell did he...
You've lost your mind. You've lost your goddamn mind, Charlie.
I'm gonna fire a beer across his bow, ruffle his feathers. Okay. Yeah, give him a good scare.
Yeah, no,
right.
Get him.
Get up, get up real close to him.
Yeah. Hey, asshole.
Ooh. Oh, shit.
Oh! No! Hey! Feels frenetic!
Huge fan, man, seriously, big time. Are you serious? Do you mean that? Bring it in, man, bring it in. Ah, yeah! All right, now seriously, man to man, mascot to mascot, I was wondering maybe if you could help get me in the game, you know, maybe hook me up with the Green Man routine. We do it at the stadium together, so. All right, now, I'm trying to talk to you, dude. I'm trying to have a conversation with you. You're belly bumping me, all right? So, all right, I'll give you. All right, don't big league me now here, man. Don't big league. Look, I'm trying to have a conversation with the man behind the mask. I feel like you're big leaguing me, dude. Are you taking me seriously?
Oh,
beating on the frenetic. Dude, is that a hate crime?
Nah, it's not a hate crime.
You want to hammer his ass anyway?
Definitely.
Guys, what are you doing?
You don't want to do this, bro.
Oh, I think I do, buddy, because I got the moves that are going to make me number one. Why don't you just go with the best dancer? Hit it.
That girl is...
If I were you, I'd take a caution before I step to meet my girl.
Oh, god damn it.
So let me tell you a little lesson, buddy. The cream always rises to the top. And I'm about to show you the white hot cream of an eighth grade boy.
Oh my god. Play the tape.
You gotta be kidding me.
Ballet.
No, but how do you remember all that choreography, man? It was like 20 years ago.
I don't know. It was beautiful, man.
All right, well, just let me do the talking.
Well, okay? I feel like you gotta at least talk with a southern accent.
No, I'm not gonna talk in a southern accent. It's bad enough that you wore this stupid disguise.
But we're oil men. We would have southern accents.
Yeah, but we don't need bolo ties and stupid
yes,
hats.
Yes, do. She's gonna pick up.
Hello, ma'am. Oh, what a lovely house dress.
Yeah, well, you're looking all sorts of good.
And now, you seem like a sweet... sophisticated, nice, busy young lady. So we're not gonna waste your time today.
Nah, we're just a couple old men in from Dallas, and well, we're itching like a hound to give you a something you want.
What my associate is trying to say is that we're here to offer your community a much needed
service. Hells yeah, we wanna fill you up, if and you were so inclined as to let us.
Please let me do the talking.
Please let me
know. Now, we ain't gonna take no for an answer now, you hear, okay? So don't be making me sick my associate on you here, all right? He don't take kindly to no. So, can I fill you up or what? Yep, you best get to stepping, because Johnny Laws are coming.
Yeah, you might want to start driving, because she called the cops on us.
Why is he talking like that?
What wildcard over here decided to lose his mind?
I say, that's just damn preposterous, boy.
Well, now you're just talking like Foghorn Leghorn.
Right, guys, I think it's time we cut our losses and go back to the original plan.
Ah, the generator.
No, not the generator. Storing the gas in patties.
All right.
Okay, it's too soon to sell this gas anyway.
Just
shut
go,
the door.
Go.
Okay.
The most important part of our routine is the entrance.
Yes, absolutely.
Frank, what the hell are you doing, man?
That's my character. I'm the trash man. I come out, I throw trash all over the ring, and then I start eating garbage. And then I pick up the trash can and I smash the guy on the head.
Oh, that's gonna be a disaster.
No, nobody's gonna get hurt. I'm telling you, it's like you said, it's all fake.
But it has nothing to do with the troops, Frank. A 60-year-old man eating trash? Who wants to see that?
No, but that's what people want.
Hey, I got something for you. I got a character for you. You can be the ref.
I'm not gonna be the ref. I'm a villain, don't you see? Look, I got garbage.
Frank! Just nasty, dude. Are you choking?
Oh, my God.
No, throw it up in the bathroom! Get out of here!
Go take a break.
The troops are going to be very happy to see that.
Mom, I'm telling you, this girl's amazing. Yeah, I got butterflies in my stomach. There's one little issue. Yeah.
Oh!
I'm good! I think you broke my nose.
That guy's beating on that chick.
Oh, my God!
Oh, no, you know, it's a dude. Yeah, she has a penis, so it's okay.
Dude, is that a hate crime? Shit, yeah, it's a hate crime!
Hello, Charlie Kelly here, local business owner and cat enthusiast. Is your cat making too much noise all the time? is your cat constantly stomping around, driving you crazy? Is your cat clawing at your furniture? Think there's no answer? You're so stupid! There is! Kitten mittens! Finally, there's an elegant, comfortable mitten for cats! I couldn't hear anything! Is your cat one-legged? Is your cat fat, skinny, or an in-between? That doesn't matter, because one size fits all. Kitten mittens, you'll be smitten. So come on down to Patty's Pub. We're the home of the original kitten mittens. Meow.
You guys feeling extreme?
This looks beautiful. Okay, you guys ready for this?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
Okay.
And action.
Cut. What the hell are you doing, dude?
That's what those tapes sound like.
Why don't you read the script that I wrote?
I'm not reading the script you wrote. It's in English. That's riddled with spelling errors.
Well, you know what I'm trying to write. Just say it.
I'm just going to mumble some guttural sounds. Let's do another one.
He's not going to know what you're saying.
Well, then we'll do subtitles or something.
I should have something in my hands.
You don't need anything in your hands.
Like a weapon, a machete, or a machine gun or something.
Okay, why don't you head down to the Wawa and pick up a machine gun?
Well, read the script.
I'm not going to read the script.
Who's the director here?
I don't care. I'm not reading the script.
All right, fine. Action!
Bro, can I get my towel over my face again?
Yeah, put your towel on your face.
All right, here we go.
Action.
I'm gonna get a weapon.
I'm gonna get a weapon. Everybody, get a weapon.
Do you think we can make this look more like a cave?
You not make restaurant here. Bad decision.
We will crush your skull with our weapons.
We can't send us.
Nope.
What are you guys talking about? We're gonna get arrested.
Yeah. When Dennis Reynolds was a counselor at Camp Cumberland, he was sent home for the statutory rape of a teenage camper. A vote for Dennis Reynolds is a vote for underage rape. Dennis Reynolds, baby rapist. Don't let him rape you, Philadelphia.
This is a goddamn smear campaign.
You raped a girl?
No. Okay, rape? I was accused of, it was, okay, statutory, first of all. Not, I kissed her. She was a year younger than me. That's not even.
Yo, Mac! You see that sign there that says toxic spill?
Yeah.
What's that?
Disregard that, Frank. It's a bunch of liberal bullshit.
Right. This is a nice spot.
Yeah. Oh! What's that? You were supposed to get booze.
Oh, this is ham soaked in rum. It is loaded with booze.
God damn it, Frank. Eating your drinks? That is genius.
Wait a minute. Where's the rum ham?
What?
Where's the rum? Rum ham!
No! Frank, stay in the boat!
Rum ham! I'm sorry, rum ham! I'm sorry! Rum ham!
Oh, rum ham! God! I love you!
Hang on!
Don't go!
I got you, brother.
No, you don't!
What are you doing?
Stop!
Why are you doing that?
I think I might get a bruise on my heel.
That's not bad.
No, it's not really bad at all. It's pretty fun. It's like, why don't you guys climb down that ladder?
All right. Later, bitches.
Listen to me very carefully, Frank. Charlie has escaped. Repeat, Charlie has escaped. I think he's going to come after you, man.
Don't worry about it. I can take care of myself. Oh. God! I just stepped in glass. There's broken bottles all over the place.
Broken bottles everywhere? Oh, shit, dude. I think you're in Charlie's bad room.
It's where he goes to be alone and break bottles. Dude, you gotta be real careful. He's gonna find you.
I could take care of myself.
Hello, Frank.
I gotta call you back.
Be careful, be careful.
Hi, Charlie.
Looking for your will, Pop?
That's exactly what I'm looking for.
You know, it's funny what kind of men we turn into in circumstances like this. I heard who you wanted to have killed.
But that goddamn Max.
And tell me, Frank, what do you think about this?
I like that very much. That's exactly why I came up here.
No, it's the... Oh, yeah, I guess it is.
Now let's get that laddie.
No, I don't think so, Frank. You see, I don't need you anymore now, do I?
What are you talking about? What are you doing? Put your hands down.
Yeah.
Charlie, put your hands down.
Yeah.
Charlie, don't lie, Dad.
Oh, my God. Do you carry that everywhere now, dude? That's ridiculous.
Lead me the hell out of here.
All right, fine.
How?
This way.
That way?
Put the gun.
I was going to go that way.
No, that would have been all wrong.
I'm telling you, Charlie, the situation is out of control. Let's just get out of here while we still can.
Without the guys?
Oh, they're as good as dead. There's no telling what those southern people are going to do to them.
You're right, man. You know what? We should just get the hell out of here. And I mean out of Philadelphia. I mean, we should just drive and drive and drive and not look back.
We should go to Arizona and open up that imported leather shop that we've always talked about.
Oh, my God. The leathers. Yes, the tasseled leathers, the turquoise studs on the leathers, all the leather.
Yeah.
Okay, do you have the keys?
Yeah,
you,
let's get the keys. Let's get the keys. Let's get out of here.
Hey.
I heard all that.
Were you holding down the button?
It was an accident. I wasn't. It was just sort of
a
reflex.
Holding that thing down. And,
well, I'm,
sorry, extraction team. We were having a leather conversation. Doesn't really. Hey, what's the status on the vase?
Do not take off on us. I repeat, do not take off on us. Leather shop in Arizona? Are you serious? There are far too many leather shops in Arizona as it is. You would be out of business in a week's time. What did you expect us to do, okay? You got us all freaked out in here, sitting here waiting for the Southerners to tie us up to horses and then have them run in opposite directions, ripping us apart.
Yeah!
How are we not supposed to fantasize about opening up imported leather shops in Arizona?
Yeah, give me a chip!
No, you're not getting the chips! The chips are off the table, okay?
I want a chip!
Don't bring
up
the chips!
Give me a chip!
He wants chips, and I asked him in the store, Dennis. You were there, I said, Charlie, do you want a bag of chips? He said, no, I don't want chips, you're not getting this. If you wanted a goddamn chip, you should have gotten a goddamn chip at the hamburger shop!
Please. You have to pee so bad.
DeAndre, your breath is dog shit.
I know.
What the hell is she doing here?
What the hell is she doing here? Really? Really? I'll tell you what I'm doing here. You want to know what I'm doing here, shit for brains? I had sex with your dad. That's right! I had sex with your father because just like you, I like my sex old and ugly and with fake hair on their heads that falls off. When you're having sex with them, it just falls off because that's what you do, Dennis Reynolds. You like to have sex with old people. And you said that you loved me. You said, I love you. And so I thought, okay, well, I love you too. How do you show love? You go and have sex with old people. So that's what I did too.
And you got the script that I wrote? Grab the script.
I've been meaning to speak to you about this. I can't read these words. They're not in the right order.
It's good.
I think you might be dyslexic, bro. I'm not reading this. I'm gonna...
No, please, read
I think
it.
You might be dyslexic.
Read the script once.
Okay, you want me to read the script?
Yes.
All right.
And action.
I'll read the words you wrote. Hello, fellow American. This you should vote. Me. I leave power. Good. Thank you. If you vote me, I'm hot.
What?
Taxes. They'll be lower. Son. The Democratic vote for me is right thing to do, Philadelphia. So do. This doesn't make any sense.
All right, well then, just say whatever you want. The battery's dead.
It's gone. I gotta charge it up again.
Hey, Frank, here's another idea.
Oh, where'd you come from?
I've been walking next to you the entire time.
Sorry, I'm a little lit, and I've been going over this thing. I'm trying to figure out how
to bang Donna. I know, you've been talking about it for the last 5 miles.
Let's cool over the interventions, though, for a second, because there's a lot of them being thrown around right now, and I'm having a little bit of trouble keeping track. The most important intervention is the one we need to do on Gail the Snail, getting her out of our lives.
Guys, let's do shots and get crazy.
No, we're intervening on you, Snail. Go, get out of here.
Yeah, right.
How is she not getting this?
She's stonewalling us. It is a classic snail technique.
Classic.
Ah, get out of here!
Oh, he's got the snail!
Get out of here, snail!
gonna invite you guys all to a rave to hang out, but now I don't wanna hang out with you anymore.
Oh my god, salt the snail! Salt the snail!
Wait!
Do you guys wanna go?
No, we don't wanna go!
Wait! I have glow sticks.
What is with that broad?
She is the worst, right? That's what we've been saying.
Oh my god, that was a terrible experience for me, by the way.
Of course it was. Nobody likes salting the snail, but she gives you no choice.
She doesn't leave you with any options.
What a horrible thing.
Yeah.
I'm all worked up now. I feel bad. I feel like maybe I should have some more wine in a can. Okay.